The moment you lose, there is no peace for the wicked. As we read in the book of Ezekiel chapter 18 verse 20, the moment you move away, you die. The man with the sin, he perishes. He perishes. That's why Psalm 146 verse 4 says, through the sin he loses the Holy Spirit and returns to the life of earth. He is busy and entangled with the earth. In that very day, all his plans perish. The power of sin and the consequence of sin. God is calling us, repent. Repent. As we read in the book of Proverbs, it is written, he who covers the sin will not prosper. If you acknowledge your sin and repent for it, and then the mercy of the Lord will come upon you. The mercy of the Lord will come upon you. We read in the book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 13. He who covers his sins will not prosper, but whoever confesses and acknowledges and forsakes it, they will receive mercy. Yes, that is when we repent, we move into the second stage called renewal. God will renew our lives. God will shed his blood upon you, and the blood of Jesus will give you new life through sin, as we read in the book of Leviticus chapter 17 verse 11. All our life streams are being dried up because of sin. As we read in Psalm 32 verse 3 to 5, Lord, when I sinned, I have become like the leaf. All my life is dried up. All my bones are loosened. I'm not able to walk. In that moment, I looked upon you, and you were so merciful. You heard me. You came to me, and you forgave me. And I received peace. That is called renewal. Whomever repents for their sins, they receive the grace. Grace is not our yearning. Grace is God's gift to us. Lot of people misunderstand the mercy and grace. Mercy is divine. Mercy is different from divine grace. Divine mercy is seeing our sin. Out of his mercy, he forgives all my sins and makes me the child of God. The grace of God means God adopts me as his own child and gives all that he has given with me, that I become partner with him to accomplish his mission on this earth. You have killed my son. I can take it in a different direction. You have killed my son. I will kill your son. That is the work of evil. I move into another direction. I cry for justice. So I put the man who killed my son into the court. And I am not happy until that man is punished. That is called the stage of justice. There is a stage of mercy. I understand in what circumstances that fellow has killed my son. I have lost my son. What is the use of crying over? I leave him. don't eat again. I just leave the scene. I just forgive him. That is called divine mercy. Out of his goodness, he forgives our sins. But divine grace means, I adopt the man who killed my son as my own son and give him all that I have. That is called the divine grace. Yes, the grace of God and the mercy of God calls each one of us to once again get back into the presence of God. Repentance basically, renewal basically involves us to getting back to the Lord, to getting back into the plan of God. With my plan, I have perished myself. Moving away from God, entangling myself with the world, as Psalm 146 verse 4 says, I have perished. All my plans are perished. The evil destroy. But renewal means I am returning back to my God with repentance. And my God sees now this man is having the power of death. Black magic is coming behind him. His curses are coming behind him. Though I have forgiven him, still his desire to go back is following him. So what will I do? I will destroy those roots of sin and once again give him the fresh water whereby the new leaves can come, new life may come, and both can be done with this power that is by his blood. The blood of Jesus has the power to destroy the works of evil. 1 John chapter 3 verse 8, the Son of Man is born to destroy the works of evil. And the blood of Jesus gives life to man. He begins to grow. Yes, newness of life. Once again, he begins to understand the plan of God. Once again, he enjoys the favor, the grace of God. Close your eyes. Place your hands over your heart. Ask the Lord. Lord, renew my life. As I repent and I am returning back to you, renew my life that I may be renewed. Jeremiah prayed, Lord, I am coming back to you. Who is Jesus? Jesus is the Lamb who forgives all our sins. Jesus is calling us, place your hands over your heart and see the Lamb. The book of Revelation chapter 5, when John was crying, there is no one to break the seal and reveal the names of people whose names are written in the book of life and take them to heaven. The one of the elders said, there is someone who is called the Lion of Judah. As John was looking, where is the lion? John saw a lamb. A lamb was slain. The blood was poured and the book of life was opened. Your life will be renewed by the Lamb's blood. When you repent and return back to the Lord, the sin, the terrible power of sin will lose its power.